Hi everyone, I am Chrissi Kelly of Absent, and today is day one of our smell training online broadcasts. I will be here every day for the next 30 days, and I am going to be smell training with you and giving you some tips. As you know, as you may have heard already, we are working with the University of Stockholm, who are doing some research into smell training, and they want to find out how people are using smell training. So if you go to the link in our bio, you will find a link that takes you to smelltrainingapp.com, and you can sign up there. And then every day when you join these live events, you can fire up the app and then enter in any information that they ask you about your smell training practice today. As you know, smell training is good for you if you've had post-viral smell loss, and it can also be good for you if you've had a head injury. There is a problem with sticking with it daily. It takes a long time to experience results. And for that reason, we decided to do this in conjunction with the University of Stockholm and just give you a little bit of extra support as you start your smell training journey. So, without further ado, I'm going to get started, and just to let you know that every day I'll be giving you a few more little bits of information so that over the course of 30 days you will get a really good grounding in what smell training is, what good smell training means, what you need to know about making your own kit, and also you could also support Absent by buying a smell training kit from us. Again, link in bio. And also giving you some tips about, why it is done the way we recommend. So, like I said, let's get started. I hope you have your own kit already. I've got four of these jars, and let's get started. So I'm going to open the first jar, and you always want to keep your jars firmly capped in between, and I'm going to put the jar to my nose and take some gentle bunny sniffs, we call them. So in between taking these bunny sniffs, you're going to want to take some regular breaths like I'm doing now, and then go back to it. It can be a discouraging the beginning of your training when you really feel like you can't smell anything. Don't worry about that. Smell training is still recommended for people who are really, really having trouble getting any kind of smell signal, but stick with it. And you want to conjure up any memories that you might have of the thing that you're smelling. So that was orange. That's one that it's relatively easy to conjure up. We all know what an orange is and what an orange feels like, what an orange looks like. And so try and engage your memory as much as possible when you're doing the smell training. Right, so the next one I have here is pine, one of my very favorite smells. I grew up near a pine forest, therefore I love this smell. Lovely. Little tiny bunny sniffs. And it's always hard to resist the temptation to close my eyes, because when I smell train, I just try and pull myself inward so that I'm just concentrating on the experience of smelling. Again, concentrating on what I'm doing, trying to paint a picture in my mind of what this smells like, what I remember about this smell. Cap on. The next one is lemon verbena. Lovely. And the last one I have here is star anise. So once again, to get my nose right down to this really concentrated airspace that's in the jar, it has a really strong scent. And that's one of the reasons why we use jars in this smell training practice, is to give you confidence that you're getting the strongest experience that you possibly can. Good. Caps on. That's the important bit. I hope you've enjoyed this. I hope you'll come back tomorrow. Turning up every day is the hard part. But do join us. You'll learn something a little bit new every day. I'm looking forward to helping you and seeing you tomorrow. So that's it for day one. And good luck with smell training. See you soon. Thanks, everyone. Bye-bye.